Yo, what up? You're watching More TV. This is Axiom, and I'm with Odario from Grand Analog. How you doing, my friend?
Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm good. Yeah. Good. Van City. I love this city.
In one simply put sentence, please explain your sound to us.
Okay.
Grand Analog sound. What is it?
All right. Hip hop, dirty hip hop, with two coats of dust and reads like an old manual no longer in use. It's dub and soul, rap and roll. It's funky shit. That's it. I grew up with skaters, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, a lot of punk rock there. Yeah, I am. Yeah, lots of punk rock.
Yeah.
And then I also, my dad's a DJ. He's a dub DJ, a reggae DJ.
Really?
Yeah, so put all that together and you got the you know, Grand Analog.
Makings of a music man.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, yeah. And I dated singer-songwriter chicks. They're the best to date.
Yeah.
Singer-songwriter girls, it's over. Oh, yeah, man. Like, they, singer-songwriter girls, when they're sick of the emo boys, they come hang out with thuggish, ruggish kids like me, and then it's a perfect combination.
Yeah, I
learned a lot of poetry from them chicks, man. I really
got the folk in there, right?
Yeah. And yeah, I got the folk and the yolk. Yeah. The yolk and the folk.
How, musically, what influences you most musically then? You talk about punk rock, you talk about old school hip hop, you talk about...
Well, you know what? Being a hip hopper, the beat, I can't write unless that beat's doing something to me. So
what do you think of Chaos and other Canadian artists and how well they're doing in globally?
Well, yeah, that's the thing. It's time now. You know, we used to be corny. You know? Canadian music, period. Canadian music was Alanis Morissette and we didn't know what to do with that.
Bare Naked Ladies.
Yeah, Bare Naked, exactly. Bare Naked Lady, the guy snorting coke on his table, and people still like, isn't he a nice boy? What was that all about? So like, yeah, you know, nowadays it's different. Like, we're respected now, finally. And I think the reason why Canadian music had a hard time catching on a global aspect is that we don't have a sound. You know, there's a British sound, you know what I mean? There's an Australian sound, there's a Japanese sound, there's even an American sound, even though...
Do you feel like Canada has a scattered sound or just...
Canada has no sound
no
whatsoever.
No sound whatsoever, just no. Not a peep from up here, eh?
You go from Feist to Chaos to Grand Analog to whatever, Bare Naked Ladies. Yeah. Like, we're all so different. And I think what it is that Canadians pull their influences from different places.
Yeah, well, we're one of the most culturally diverse countries in the world, so...
Yeah, and see, like, Americans, they are influenced by themselves.
Yeah.
That's why you see a kind of a full circle with them.
So,
they only influence themselves.
On that note, you could say we're in a less self-serving country.
Yeah, that's a good way of putting it, man. It's a really good way of putting it. I think we're a lot more open-minded to what's going out there. Like, if a Canadian's really influenced by something going on in, say, Japan, it will come out in their music. And it will differentiate them from everyone else.
Yeah.
And it's not a Canadian sound.
Well,
you'll find that
a lot of Canadian artists do well in Japan, right?
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. We just put out a new single out there, and it's starting to heat up a little bit.
Well, that's good.
I don't even know if they know what I'm saying.
Yeah, that's what I always wondered. Like, where's the language barrier end, you know what I mean? She was a girl from the city's east side. I got a love from them Betty Boop eyes. I'm on that, would you be my concubine? We play house in the west, it was nice to cry.
That's your dog!
Well, what do you think about... What do you think about bilingual hip-hop? Like, there's a lot of really, really dope shit that's, like, in Spanish. I can't tell what's going on. But,
yeah.
But I find that, like, you can really appreciate the flow of a completely different language. It's like a new set of rules, right?
Yeah. You can appreciate the flow.
The cadence is going to have more, like, opportunities in different areas.
And I like the way they have, they're kind of powered by revolution, almost. Mm-hmm. Like, every other country with their hip-hop, they use hip-hop as a tool to fight something, man.
Well,
you know what I mean?
Explore, right?
Yeah, especially the Spanish. when they're rapping, they always got their fists going like this, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, even if they're saying, drink more alcohol, they're still making it sound like you gotta, like, do it with all your heart, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So, what do you want to say about Peg City? That's where you're hailing out of, right?
Peg City. I coined that term.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, man. I came up with that word, Peg City, because I put on a hip-hop festival called Peg City Holla.
Yeah, you ever heard of Dan Savage?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You know what he calls, you know what pegging is?
No, please tell me.
I don't think we're going to use this, but that's when a dude gets his girlfriend to wear a strap on. That's pegging.
Nice. Oh, I never realized that. It makes a whole lot of sense.
It's horrible, isn't it?
A little bit of pegging and pooping after that. Yeah, yeah. Peg City is unique. I've been to every city from, you know, from Halifax to Vancouver. We are a unique bunch, and we fight a lot. We fight with each other all the time because I think we just want to see the city do its thing, you know, and we're all so different. So we support each other in odd ways, man.
Oh, Dario, my man, it's been good chilling with you.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Have a good show,
man. Man City, I love this place. Wicked. Wicked, man.